Hi again, YouTubers. This is a review on the Sonia Kashuk blending sponge that looks like this. You guys saw it in a couple of my hauls and you asked about it. I took some time with this because I've tried it with a couple different foundations and I've tried it wet, I've tried it dry, I've tried it a couple different ways. I did use it today. I used it with my Kors foundation. What I find is the thicker the foundation it is, it doesn't work as well. Like, I don't personally like this with the Studio Sculpt foundation. I don't like it. I tried it with my Dior Nude. I didn't like it with that. The ones that it tended to work with were my Kors and my MAC Mineralized Satin Finish. These are the two that it tended to work with. And those are a thinner consistency of foundation. So it blends a little bit easier and it works a little bit better. So I like this. It's $9. I'm not particularly much of a sponge person anyway. I tend to use my brushes or my fingers. Most recently my fingers with the Dior Nude and the Studio Sculpt. I don't like them with brushes, but the rest of mine I do tend to use my brushes with, and I tend to use just a little sponge like this, your little squares, or triangles or whatever they're called. I tend to use those to blend areas around my nose and things like that. However, this is kind of cool. It's kind of like a pouncing motion that you use. And this is the less expensive version of the beauty blender that you can buy at Sephora.com and a couple other places online. I will say it is about, I think for two of them on Sephora.com with the cleanser, it's like $34. For one of these, it's like $10. But I've used it 5 times. And I'm careful about washing it, and I wash it every time afterwards. But can you see that? It's falling apart already. I just finished washing this too, but it's falling apart. So after 5 uses, it has already started falling apart. So I'm really hoping that the Beauty Blender one doesn't do this. I will say a couple other things. I did try it when it was damp. I very lightly rinsed it under some water and then squeezed it all out and made sure that it was just damp. And I tried it that way and I felt like it soaked my foundation into the sponge more, which technically it should create a barrier and allow it to sit on top. But for some reason with this one in particular, it kind of soaked in and you can see how it's stained it a little bit. So I don't know, here's my thoughts. I personally, because I'm not much of a sponge person, I would not suggest going to buy this for the $10. It's only lasted me a couple weeks before it fell apart, started falling apart. I can only imagine the more I wash it, the more it's gonna fall apart. Hopefully the Beauty Blender one doesn't. I haven't decided whether I'm going to get that or not yet, because honestly, this I don't grab for. I prefer my brushes. So I'm glad I tried this one for the $10 as opposed to spending $35 and then finding out the same thing that I just really don't like using the sponge. It's a cool idea. It's a great concept. If you are a sponge person or a finger person, it does take a lot of time. If you have ever used a 187, the stippling brush, let me grab one. If you ever used this brush, how you just stipple it on and you pounce it, because these are not made to be brushed on, you actually pounce this. This is the same movement. You're actually just pushing it into your skin. I don't want to get too much on my face because it's kind of damp and it'll mess up my makeup. But if you have tried this and you don't like taking so much time by doing that, the stippling effect, you're not gonna like this because it has similar effects. You have to use it in a pouncing motion. You can't use this like a regular sponge by just kind of like quickly going over it. This takes time. So if you're not willing to take the time to use this properly, it's not gonna do the effect that you're looking for. So my thoughts are, if you are going to give these a try and you can find the one that's, I think it's one brush and one sponge and a cleanser is like $29.99 and then, or $25.99, something like that. And two of them with a cleanser is like $34. Hopefully they don't fall apart. This one for $10, guys, a couple weeks and it's already fallen apart. I just don't find it's worth the money that I spent on it, honestly. So I hope this review is helpful to you guys. And if you have any questions about any of the products you saw here or anything about that product, put a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks so much, guys, and have a good day. Bye.